As a man, I know that one of the things that many men do is watch porn. And this video today is going to be one of the most personal ones that I've probably done in a while. And it's going to go deep into why I decided to give up porn and the things that I learned from the past 30 days from giving it up. So I'm going to give you guys a little bit of backstory. So me and my friend were eating out. We went to Korean barbecue and he tells me about this thing called NoFap. He's telling me how he wants to do 90 days without masturbating or without watching porn because of all the benefits that come with that, seeing how he could change as a person, testing his dependency on masturbation, seeing if he can go without masturbating for at least one day. Now, if you guys don't know what NoFap is, here's a little quick summary of what it is. NoFap is a comprehensive community-based porn recovery website. We offer all the tools our users need to connect with a supportive community of individuals determined to quit porn use and free themselves from the compulsive sexual behaviors. With our website, forums, articles, and apps, NoFap helps our users overcome their sexual addiction so they can heal from porn-induced sexual dysfunctions, improve their relationships, and ultimately live their most fulfilling lives. So that was the first I've ever heard of it, but one of the things that really drew me was the determination and willpower of these people who abstain from masturbating or watching porn. Because I have seen certain things in certain videos and certain articles that talked about the importance of quitting porn because of the negative side effects it can give you. But honestly, I never really cared too much or really wanted to try it. But with my friend doing it, I told him, hey, you know what? I'll do it with you. So for the next 90 days, we decided to give up porn. Today is actually day 30 for me, and I wanted to make this video to kind of go over what I've learned and why I actually have decided to quit porn for good. Now, this is a personal part. I started watching porn when I was like, when I was 13 or 14. You know, you have friends who bring magazines to school and then you have them talking about it during lunch. And then you kind of say, all right, I'm gonna go see what it's like to actually view this. But it was one of those times where like I found something that was new and was exciting and that I liked. So I kept doing it and watching it and watching it. So for the last maybe 10 years, I've been using, you know, porn and stuff like that to masturbate and kind of release my sexual tension. But when I started doing this 30-day challenge, or when I was like in around the middle of the month and I realized how I've actually gone like 2 weeks without masturbating or watching porn, I was like, wow, I have a lot more willpower than I thought. I can do things that I didn't really know that I could do, because I'm not gonna lie, there were some times where I did want to go back and I did want to watch a video, or I did want to do things that I normally would have done before, but I actually held on and I didn't really look at porn whatsoever. Yes, there were times where like I wanted to, but surprisingly, I stayed put. As I did more and more research regarding this topic, I realized there are a lot of negative side effects that come with porn, and I want to talk about them right here today. The number one thing that I found really interesting was erectile dysfunction. So if you guys don't know what erectile dysfunction is, it's basically when a guy cannot sustain an erection for a short or long period of time during sexual activity. And studies have found that usually porn and erectile dysfunction can be linked together, because a lot of times guys would rather watch porn, or they would rather watch certain scenes that they've grown accustomed to instead of actually having sex. Or when it comes down to actually having sex, they don't feel the same pleasure, or they have a hard time getting hard because it's not the scene that they're accustomed to. So for one, it can ruin your sex life, and on the other hand, it can cause you to become dependent on porn. So that's definitely a big one, and that's one that I think most guys should look into, because they might not know it, but they might be more dependent on porn and they might find themselves getting more turned on and more hard during porn scenes than actually having sex. So they might end up actually just going and watching porn to go jack off. The second thing that I found interesting about porn is that it can actually cause you to become less reliant on going out and meeting people. Now, if you guys are someone who don't date a lot, or someone that you just prefer not to go out and put yourself out there, then porn and pleasuring yourself can be such an easy way to get off, because all you need is a computer, lotion, and your hand. And that's all it takes. There's no commitment, there's no driving. All it is just you and your laptop just in your room and just wanking it off. But one of the things that I found it does is that many guys who do this, they tend to be complacent and they tend to just rather go for the masturbation and the porn instead of actually going out and meeting someone. So the mindset would be, oh, why do I need to go meet someone when I just have my hand and the lotion and this laptop full of endless videos? Because honestly, like, yes, masturbation I think is healthy and it's essential to releasing your sexual pleasure. But I don't think it beats actual intimate sex with another person, because it feels a lot better, you're getting more gratification from it, and you're sharing a social intimacy with that person that you don't share when you're doing it by yourself. It's not a knock on masturbation in general, I'm just saying that some guys and some girls maybe tend to look at it as a way to kind of just get away from dating, or get away from actually trying to go out and meet people and have sex, and instead just look at things like, okay, well, I have this, so I don't really need it. Now, the third and final thing that I found that's related to porn and negative side effects when it comes to your own personal and sexual life is you might become dependent on certain scenes that get you off. Because speaking from my own personal experience, there are some times where like a certain video will be better than another video. Or when you watch that video for a certain amount of time, you have to go to another video because that video you basically jacked off to it so many times. You need something new and you want to get something new and fresh. Sometimes it can become a problem because when you're bored of all the normal stuff, you know, you might start searching for, oh, let me search for, you know, cages or whips or choking and things like that. Things that really, you know, they might happen in real life. But I honestly don't think that a lot of the stuff that's really dangerous and kind of kinky happens in real life, especially from my own personal experience. Yes, it's fun to play around and do dress up and maybe do like new things here and there, but it's not to the point where you want to like chain someone up or start choking them or slapping them really hard or spitting in their mouth, things like that. And some guys can become addicted to that certain kind of porn where they look at those videos and think that they can only get hard from that. They no longer can get hard from either normal sex, a woman, or they just find themselves being only attracted to these certain extreme scenes. Yeah, if we go over the list, it is porn can cause erectile dysfunction. Number 2, it can cause you to become complacent and not go out and meet people. And 3, it can cause you to become addicted and only attracted to certain explicit extreme scenes. Also, one last thing, I don't want to put a downer on masturbation because I do think masturbation is a healthy and natural thing because there are some times where we're by ourselves and we do need to release some sexual tension in our own bodies. And I think that's totally fine. But it becomes a problem when you need porn only, when you need certain scenes, when it kind of gets in the way of your sexual life, it gets in the way of your personal life, and that's when it becomes a problem. I think the only time I would suggest, you know, giving masturbation a break is when you find some irritation down there because, you know, I've had that too where like I remember when I just started when I was like 13 or 12, I was going like every day. And after a while, my dick was pretty much red and it was throbbing. So that's the only time I would recommend quitting and going easy on yourself. So if you're a guy out there and you're thinking about quitting porn, try giving it 30 days. See if you can go 30 days without watching any porn and see how you do. See how your body reacts. See how your sex life changes. See how your personal life changes. See how your social settings change where you don't need porn all the time. You're not feeling like you're getting addicted or you're dependent on it. And that's a really good thing. It shows determination, it shows self-improvement, it shows resilience in yourself that you could actually do this and you're not dependent on something for your whole life. I hope you guys found some very informative things from this video. And as always, I will please like and subscribe and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.